so originally I was going to do a lead, and we ended up doing a flute. So I'm going to carry on and do a lead. That's been an oscillator one. Leads are always good when it's sawtooths. Squares are great for if you're using some kind of ring mod, but ring modulation or sync or something like that. So what we're going to do, let's have some pitch thing going on, okay? Oscillator 2. Chord, better chorus tune. What should we have? Should I have that? Yeah, let's have that as a square. Seventh. Yeah, they're working against each other quite nice. It's not perfect, so. It's about 73. Probably perfect would be about 75. Just guessing, I suppose. Oh, sound police are coming to get me. Now, I've got oscillator 2 a little bit lower in terms of volume, because we still want the dominant pitch to be oscillator 1, or whatever the dominant pitch is going to be, have that louder. Now, that is an octave. It's not an octave higher, it's seven notes higher, but if we do knock oscillator 2 up an octave, it'll still then be 7, so whatever, 19 notes higher. Kind of works that, doesn't it? So just turn down oscillator 2 a bit more, because still it's a higher pitch, so we'll hear it more prominently. That's a square. Now let's see what this... that nasty thin pulse width is like. Do you know, that's all right, that. So, saw. Square. So that pulse sounds a little like the saw, doesn't it? Saw. Kind of like that. We're going to use that, so we're going for the pulsey thing on oscillator 2. Let's just turn down, let's write this for now, just so I can go back to it if I need to, because I'm going to turn down oscillator 1, just to have oscillator 2. And we're going to add that sync thing. Let's turn it to, what should we have it as, envelope. And then for this, it's going to be some... what should we do? No, let's have it to LFO, because then we haven't got to the envelope yet. Now, I've gone minus on the LFO, but the LFO rate is quite slow. Ooh. Want some cheesy 60s organ. Actually, I've not put it in mono, have I? Do you know? Let's have a listen. Anyway, scrub that. We're not doing that. Put it in mono mode. Turn down the LFO rate. I want it quite slow. I only want subtle movement. That's sync. Now, if I use the metalizer, it will go, or the metal side, it will drift in and out of pitch. And that breaking up is, it's moving away from synchronization from the first oscillator. So let's turn it down the pitch. Bring up oscillator one now. So what's happening there is we've got oscillator one, we've got oscillator two synced to it, but because it's the metal, we're still drifting in and out of tune, just oscillator two. It's a little dirtied up, so let's go to condition. Sounds like it's altered the phase a little bit. It's around 77. See, there's no exact science. It's like, you know, when you see a chef, you know, they're not there all measuring and getting the spoons and leveling it. Well, they're just chucking it in, aren't they? It's a gut thing. And that's what sound design should be about, in my view, anyway. I kind of like that. There's a sync sound element to it, but there's also a bit of a drift. Okay, so that's for our tonal variety. We could try it on unison, but it tends to be just a load of notes stacked. And you get that horrible plasticky chorus sound. It's not just because it's a digital synth, it's even the Dave Smith stuff does that. But just mono. Right, so in terms of, now we'll move on to the amp section, and you can kind of start off with a gated type sound, on and off, for the amp. But we're going to have a little bit of a lip on the front of it, like we did with the wind sound. Just to get rid of clicks. And the same with release. Because we're in mono, and it's re-triggering the envelope each time we replay the note, we won't hear the release portion. You know, it's not getting to the release, it's just being re-triggered. It's just going 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. It's only when we let go that we're going to get that. But of course, once we start using the filter, we'll hear less of that release. Right, so let's keep it easy. We'll do a positive envelope. Turn all those sliders down, cut off all the way down, envelope all the way up. It's going to be, put the key release, key follow all the way up. So it's brighter at the top, darker at the bottom. Just because that's the way it is. And we've got nothing. So we're going to bring up the attack amount. It's just a little bit, because we'll hear the sound with the decay. But just a little bit of a lip on the attack. It's like some cheesy old monosynth. Adding that condition and the sync, it's like you can, I don't know if you can hear it or whether you'll hear it on the stream, but It's like there's noise there, but there isn't any. Right, we'll add a bit of velocity sensitivity, so it will get brighter now. Once we, in fact, we'll turn it off for now because we haven't finished the envelope yet. So we don't want it to fade out to nothing. So while it's gone through attack, it's gone through decay, keep the key held down, lift it up. That's where our resting point is going to be. We can have it brighter, but usually for leads, you'll have it around around there. So it's... You can hear some of that, because of that pitch going slowly in and out. It's like doing the beating with the oscillators. It's going fast and then slow. Of course, it'll change no matter, whatever key we use. So I've got that. Now that might be too bright, so this is where we hone in with the envelope going negative on the envelope amount. Let's just bring up a bit of release though for the filter. So I brought down the envelope amount, and what that will do is, say for instance, on full, the time it takes to go through the attack through there, say it's 1 second, whatever like that, you reduce that, and so you're reducing the amount of time. Of course, it depends on what that level is. It's all ratios. I hope you remember maths from school. And bring up the cutoff a bit. It's got a bit of a brassy quality to it. I don't mind that. We make it more synthy with some resonance, but of course we're going to lose the body a little bit. Well, quite a lot, actually. Leave that off. Let's do the velocity. So it'll probably go brighter the harder we hit it and go darker. But it's more of a feel. So that's how we can get our sort of dynamics in there. Go to legato again, so it's not re-triggering the envelope. The envelope doesn't get re-triggered, but that carries on. And then a bit of portamento. Let's write that for now. And we go to menu, and we go to our patch edit. We don't want a bend range of 3. Now we haven't used... Oh, yes, we have. We have used the LFO, so we can't bring in any sort of vibrato. Otherwise, if we bring it in, it'll just be slow. But because it is slow, it will help actually with us using the filter. So once it goes to dark, now we bring it up, we'll go brighter. There we go. So we're kind of mimicking vibrato to a degree. Or wah-wah, whatever you want to call it. Now, so we've got that. I kind of like the shape of it. It's going in and out of sync, out of phase. Turn down that key follower a bit. It's going a bit too dark down there. Maybe a touch too much portamento. better, but it doesn't re-trigger the envelope. Strange. Right. Enter. That's honed in a little bit more. Now we've got our three things. Do we add chorus, make it traditional? There is a noise on the chorus. Yeah, why not? Let's go to the JX3P chorus. Add noise. Can't see the point myself, but then let's just add the chorus. Let's brought out the noise a bit more. That's not noise from the chorus effect. Weird. I've not put it all on, I've put it three quarters. Right, and then we can have some. What do we want? Open up stereo. Not particularly. No, we'll just have a single delay. And then we'll get rid of the bright repeats. Effects. Touch effects. Delay. Pre-delay. It's on the reverb. We've not got any of that on. Type delay, time, do we want tempo sync it? Yeah, may as well. That's 1/16th. That's starting to sound like a crappy reverb, isn't it? So let's just increase that. I'll turn it, yeah, what am I doing? Back to menu, patch effects. I'll turn in tempo sync off for that. I'm going to do it more of a feel. And then we'll turn off the brightness. Is there too much feedback? It defaults at 120, so all it does is just you reduce it and just reduces the amount of repeats. A delay is good, especially quick delay, things like that, because it keeps the sound up front, but will still allow it to sit in a mix. Let's knock off some of the high end, so about 1.6. So write that, and then this is where we can just dial things in. I mean, you could add a touch of reverb if you want. Use the modulated reverb again, have it the time about 90%, but only a little touch of level. Off the high end of the reverb. Change it to 25 milliseconds, it's just something I do. High cut's on 8 kilohertz, so we're going to whack that right down to 1.6.
Mm-hmm.
write it. And of course, the chorus is only, you know, probably two thirds of the way. So we can dial it in and out now. Off. Oh, we could use a different effect. Let's try the distortion. What am I doing here? Oh. I hadn't hit patch right, yes. So when you don't do that and it's waiting for that, it doesn't matter what you're turning, it won't... Let's exit that. Let's try that again. So back to chorus. Oh, we're still in that mode. Enter. Yeah, it's like when it's waiting to be written, it won't do anything. I suppose it's a good thing in the end, but it's fiddling around with me knobs. Nothing was happening. Very distorted. Dirty. But I'm going to keep it at chorus. Tone off so there's no noise. There we go. Yeah. I think something's wrong with a cable or something. Let's turn it up full. Too much. So more or less where it was. So write that. Anything, I'm not 100% sure, is that reverb? It's like it's an afterthought. I'm going to knock the level of that down. And then I'm going to increase the... because we cut the top end off those delays, makes it sound like it's the feedback shorter. I'm going to add a little bit more of the feedback so it starts to cover. Because what was happening before, it sounded to me that the sound would end, the delays would happen, the delays would disappear, and then we'd just get this of the reverb. So I'm trying to now stir it all in the pot a little bit so it blends. Dirty. Neat sound.